Good morning, everyone, and you're very welcome back to Age and Opportunity's Movement Minutes with myself, Paul. I hope you're having a lovely bank holiday weekend, and I hope you're able to join us now this morning in some gentle, relaxed movements, as we always do when we come outside to the great outdoors. I'm coming to you live this morning from South Donegal, and as I look down towards the Atlantic, it's fairly fresh here this morning now, slightly windy, so hopefully the mic is okay and the wind won't interfere too much with us. And I know Ross is joining us from Port New this morning, which, as the crow flies, is just in this direction here behind me. So if there's any issues, since we're coming outside, if there's any issues with the sound or the picture, just let me know and I'll check it during the session as well. All you're going to need this morning is just your chair, yourself, and if you have it, just to have nearby a glass or a bottle of water just that you can sip from throughout the session. So we're just going to give it a few more seconds, folks, just for people to get settled in and get tuned in. And again, any issues around this. Okay, folks, so everything looks okay there. So I'll just ask you now, when you're ready, just to assume your position on your chair. So just sliding forward from the back of the chair, sitting towards the front, sitting up nice and tall. And we're just going to lift the shoulders up and just roll them back. We're going to take both our hands in, just place them at the centre of our chest, elbows down by the side, and closing the eyes, we're going to inhale in through the nose. And as we do so, in through the nose, exhale out. From there, relax the hands by the side. You can open the eyes again. We're going to get set up and we're good to go. And I see we have Kathleen there with us as well. So Kathleen, you're very welcome to Donegal. I know it's a nice holiday destination of yours, so I hope you enjoy the backdrop that we have here this morning. So just starting off nice and easy, folks. We're just going to take the right hand, index finger then of the left hand, we're just going to apply a small bit of pressure on each finger of the right hand, okay? So we're just going to go over and back three times. And last time now, we're going to hold those fingers back just a second longer, with the index finger of the opposite hand of our left hand, then we're going to do the same with the index finger of the right hand. Just nice and gentle, again just over three times, so nice and steady, just a gentle push, and last time now, great stuff. From there now we're going to revert back to our right hand, we're going to turn our palm away from us, we're going to straighten out our arm, with our opposite hand then, the left hand, we're just going to grab the fingertips and just pull them back towards us. And we're going to hold that stretch. So all the movements today are just going to be gentle stretches. So we're going to change over now to the left hand. Just holding it there nice and easy. And from there then we're just going to place our fists just in front of our shoulders. We're going to open out the hands and we're going to clench the fists then as we pull back out. So out and in, out and then just reaching all the way out, really exaggerating it. Sitting nice and tall in the chair, it's just the arms that are moving. Tall. Three, two, and one. For next movement then, you have two options. You can either place the hands together in prayer, or you can interlock the fingers, whichever you prefer. So we're just going to rotate the wrists around. So the fingers, the middle fingers at the top, we're just drawing very, very small circles. Tucking the elbows in by the side, So again, it's just the wrists that are moving, and then we're going to go in an anti-clockwise direction then as well. So just around nice and easy for 3, 2, and 1. Great stuff. We can place the hands now, we can shake out the arms as well. Place them by the side. We're going to take our left hand now, place it at the center of our chest, and our right hand is just hanging down nice and relaxed. Okay, we're going to lift the right shoulder up and we're going to roll it back. And we're going to do 5 of these. 3, 2, and 1. Nice and relaxed down again. Okay, and then we're going to lift it up again and we're going to roll the shoulder forward this time. So again for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. From there then we're going to change hands. So right hand on the center of the chest, left hand just hanging nice and relaxed down by the side of the body. We're lifting up, rolling back, up and back for 2 and 1. And then this time again we're going to lift it up for 3, 2, and 1. Great stuff. Again, just shaking out the arms again, making them nice and limber. We're going to take both our hands now and we're just going to place them at the base of our back. Okay, so just in front of the hips, and then we're going to try and squeeze our elbows together. Okay, so just pushing the elbows together and then get the chair for 3, 2, and 1. And we can relax them again by the side. Again, just sitting up nice and tall. And from there then, a big thumbs up, okay, in this bank holiday Monday for the morning. And then we're just going to rotate it as down as far as we can and back up. And again, just slowly on the way down and back up. So we're going from a thumbs up to a thumbs down. Thumbs up. Rotating the shoulder, rotating the elbow and the arm here as well. Okay, so 2 more. And last one. Again, just place the hand by the side. Right hand out the centre of the chest. Left hand out in front. And we're thumbs down. Thumbs up. Thumbs down. Thumbs up. Hopefully I'm getting more thumbs up than thumbs down there this morning. I hope anyway. We're going to go for 2 more, and last one. Great stuff. From there, again, feet planted, nice and flat on the ground, a good support base, 4 legs of the chair and our own 2 legs. Okay, sitting up nice and tall in the chair. We're going to make a fist with our left hand, and we're going to grab our left hand in with our right. So just grab it around like so. We're going to hold it into the chest, and we're just going to stir. Okay, so as we stir, we slightly lean out to the side, slightly lean forward, out to the right, and back in, okay? So it's not just the hands or the arms that are just moving around the torso, just around the middle of the body. So whatever directions our hands are going, our torso slightly leaning to the left, slightly leaning forward, slightly right, and back up top. And I'm going to go for 3 more. Last 2. And last one, and from there then we're going to reverse the direction. So we're going to go anti-clockwise, taking it back in, out and around, and all the way back in. Great stuff, just nice and steady. 4, 3, 2, and last 1. And all the way back in. Again, just relaxing out the hands, shaking out the arms. From there then, we're just going to place our hands just on top of our laps, okay, about halfway on top of our laps. And what we're going to do again, we're going to move the hands forward, both at the same time, to our knees, and we're going to lean the body forward. And as the hands come back, the bodies come back, okay? So from a side view, we're just going to lean forward, sit up, and lean forward, and sitting up nice and tall. We'll go for 3 more of these. Last 2, 1. Great stuff. From there then we're going to move it on to the hips. Okay, so we're just coming down the body, one joint and muscle at a time. So we're going to place the right foot out in front, heel is placed on the ground, the toe is pointing up towards the sky or up towards the ceiling. Okay, so again just sitting up nice and tall off the big toe. So we're going to make a wiper, a windscreen wiper, just out of our big toe. So we're just gently moving it from side to side, and again you'll get the rotation then just in your hip as well. Okay, so we're trying to keep the leg, there might be a slight bend in the knee but not too much. We're trying to keep the leg as straight as possible. Okay, so again that windscreen wiper is just going from side to side, and go for 3, 2, and 1. You can take that foot back in, the left foot now goes out, heel placed firmly on the ground. Okay, toe again pointing up towards the sky or the ceiling. And we're just going to rotate it from side to side, right to left, nice and gentle. And each one of these movements now, again, we're concentrating on our breathing as well. So our breathing is just nice and relaxed. Okay, it's not too strenuous. Just nice, relaxed breathing. And again, we're getting our gentle movements then as well. Last 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're going to take that foot back in. We're just going to hover the foot a few inches, maybe 2 or 3 inches off the ground. And we're going to use our knee now, okay? So our knee is a pen. And what we're going to do, we're going to draw very small circles with the pen. So again, we're just lifting it up. So the foot here is maybe 3 or 4 inches off the ground. We lift it to the side and we lift it to where it's maybe 6 or 8 inches off the ground. And back around. So we're just lifting it higher and releasing it down lower. Drawing small circles just with our imagination. And then we're going to go in an anti-clockwise direction. That's it, and we're going to go for 5 more, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Placing the foot back on the ground. If you find that too much, if you find maybe 8, too much beginning off, what you can do is start small with 4, and then swap back to the original leg then again. So again, foot about 2 or 3 inches off the ground. First, just draw on those circles with our knee. Again, you can place your hand on top or place it by the side. Now, so we're going clockwise. 5, 4, 3, 1. Okay, if you'd like more of a challenge, if it's something you want to do in your own time, just to fully extend out your leg, point your toe directly away from you, and use your big toe then as your pen. Okay, so it will be a bit harder than just the knee. You can do clockwise and anti-clockwise as well if you want in your own time. Okay, so from there, what I'll ask you to do now is just take both your hands, just grab the sides of the chair, again sitting up nice and tall. We're going to lift the foot again about 2 inches off the ground, and we're going to extend the leg out and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. Sorry, the right foot, the left foot comes up, and extending the leg out in front again. We're going to hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Back to the first foot, reaching out in front, extend and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And back down and off the left now for the last time. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And back on the ground again. Okay, so we're just going to relax for a second. Now we're going to do that once more. If you need now, and as the sun comes out, we're blessed. Somebody must have been saying a few prayers here, because we normally don't get sun up this far north. So whoever was praying this morning, thanks for getting us a bit of sunshine. You can take your drink of water now if you wish. And then again, just placing it out of harm's way, hoping it doesn't fall over. Okay, so again, just holding the hands by the side, and we're going to lift it up, and we're going to hold it this time for 8 seconds. Just out in front for 4, 3, 2, and 1, and back down. Off the left leg now again, just all the way up in front. 4, 3, 2, down, and last time now again off the right, and we'll try for 10 seconds this time. Okay, see how long. If you can't manage to hold it up for 10, that's okay. You can drop it down gently, take it back up when you're ready. 4, 3, two, and one, and relax down. And last, I should have to get sunglasses now. I'm being blinded by the sun here at the minute. Doesn't normally happen. Four, three, two, and one, and back down. Okay, from there then, we're just going to place both our feet flat on the ground, hands just on our knees, and we're going to swish our ankles just from side to side. So just over and back, just nice and easy. Four, three. We're going to place our heels on the ground this time, and it's our toes that are going to move from side to side, okay? So, heels on the ground, toes moving just side to side. Just tapping to the beat. You've got music on there in the background. Four, three, two, and one. From there then, we're going to place our feet just flat on the ground again. We're going to keep our toes on the ground as before. Hands on the knees, and we're just going to lift the heels up as high as we can. Again, maybe 2 or 3 inches. And back down, just as high as you can lift them up. And back down. And applying a small bit of pressure, now not too much, just on the knees, just to make it a bit more difficult. Create a bit more resistance. Five, four, three, two, and one. From there then, we're going to plant our heels this time, and our toes are going to go up towards us, okay? So we're lifting the toes off the ground. Mightn't be as high this time, maybe just an inch or two. So again, just lifting the heels up front, just tapping our feet down. You can do it to your hands as well at the same time if you wish. That's four, three, two, and one. And the last one now, just for the legs, mainly for the hips on this one, we're going to spread our feet out nice and wide, okay? So just wider than our shoulders. And what we're going to try and do, sit up nice and tall, if you can. You may find that you may need to lean forward a small bit just to meet, but if you can, just try and stay nice and tall. You're going to have your hands just inside your knees, and you're going to lift your left heel up towards your right hand, just to tap it if you can, okay? And again, off the other side, so just nice and easy. Again, you may find that you need to lean a small bit forward, that's okay, but as long as it's not too much. And if you find that you can't actually tap your heels with your hands, that's perfectly okay as well. Just take it in the same direction, like so. Okay, we're going to go for five, four, three, two, and one. Great stuff. Final one now, we're just going to finish off. It's a very important one for the back, okay, and it comes from yoga. I think I've done it before. It's called a cat cow stretch, okay? So I'm going to move to the side again, just so you can get a better view of it. You're going to take both your hands, okay? You can sit as normal in the chair. I'm just doing this for demonstration. So you're going to take both your hands, you're going to point your fingers towards each other, and place them just on the top of your laps, like so. Elbows out to the side, and what we're going to do, we're going to try and round the back, a nice curve on the back, like so. Just like you would see a cat do, okay? We're just going to curve forward, bringing the shoulders forward, taking the head in slightly. And then we're going to get an outward curve on the back as well, okay? So we're just going to push the shoulders back, head goes back as well, but not too much. The hands remain on the knees or on the laps. And then we're going to lean forward again, just for a stretch. Again, that nice curvature of the back. We're just leaning forward like so, just a nice curve on the back. And then we're making that S. For outward curve. Okay, so just pushing the shoulders back, nice and easy. Last one there, we're going forward for that inward curve. And back out for our outward curve then. From there, you just shake out the legs. We'll finish off now. One body part we haven't done this morning is the toes. So just when you're sitting there, you just scrunch the toes like you hold your fingers. So just scrunch them back, wiggle them around. Scrunch, wiggle, scrunch, and wiggle. Okay, and before we go now, as always, we're just going to take both hands, just place them at the centre of the chest. Again, elbows by the side, and when we close the eyes, as we inhale, we're going to lift the elbows up. So inhaling in through the nose, exhaling out through the mouth. And again, in through the nose. Big exhale out through the mouth. And last one now, big deep breath in. And exhaling out. And just in your own time, just placing the hands on your laps and keep the eyes closed. And when you're ready, then you can slowly begin to open them. Okay, so thanks very much, folks, today. I'm just going to check to see if everybody's still there, if everybody's still awake. I think we have. And we have Phyllis and John. Good morning, folks. Thanks for joining us. We have Alan and Cian getting ready for their big game this morning, or this afternoon as well. So you should be well limbered up now, lads. So thanks again for joining us this morning, folks. And here in Donegal, I'm glad the wind actually wasn't too bad, surprisingly. And the rain held off, and we have the sun out now, which is great. I hope you enjoy the rest of your bank holiday Monday. Hope you found that beneficial. And again, as always, if you want to do it in your own time, later on the day or later on the week, you have the option to play it back either here on Facebook or on our YouTube page as well. So I'm going to be back as normal this Wednesday for our standing session at 11 a.m. Hope you can join me for that. And following on then on Friday, Barbara will be here, as she has been for the last few weeks, at 11 a.m. I think it's strength that she's doing this week, so we hope you can join her for that. So again, folks, I hope you enjoy the rest of the day. If you can get some movement in tomorrow, either by watching back our own videos, that'll be great. And I'd see you back here then on Wednesday for our live session. As always, stay active, stay safe, and most importantly, stay well. Take care.